Show, starring Betty Hutton. As Goldie.
You mean you really talked Goldie into having a rest? That doesn't sound like her.
I insisted on it. So I sent her up to our country home.
You're right, Pat. She's tired. She's always doing something for somebody else. Too many people take advantage of her good nature.
Well, not this time. I've taken care of everything. There won't be a soul up there that she knows. She can't get involved.
Gee, I can see her now. Lying on her back in the sunshine, relaxing.
Wow, it's hot. Hand me a towel.
Miss Appleby, you shouldn't be out here in this hot sun trying to help us fix our car.
I'm sorry.
We read in the papers that you were up here to get a real good rest.
We just wanted to use your phone.
Oh. You know something? It's no use. This old wreck has had it. Tell me, isn't that kind of dangerous, hauling kids around in a thing like this?
Well, it's all we can afford. You see, the foster home isn't a sponsored charity. Mrs. Blaker and I founded the home ourselves. Well, it hasn't been too easy lately.
Now, Father, don't bother this nice young lady with our troubles.
You're right, Mother.
Miss Appleby, if you'll pardon us, we better start walking. We've got to get back to the children.
Walking? What do you mean?
Well, we've just been out trying to raise some money, and we had to leave them alone.
You mean you left all those kids alone?
Well, we can't afford any help yet. But you know the old saying, there's always hope. Maybe by next Christmas.
Next Christmas? But that's terrible. Now, look, you two wait right here. I'll get my car and drive you home myself.
She bit. What'd I tell you, baby? She took the bait like there's no tomorrow.
What a sucker. There's one born every minute.
Now, thanks to Gobble Goldie, that little, foster home swindle should net us at least 20 grand.
Now, hear this. I all want you to listen to your leader. That's me. Okay?
Okay.
Now, I all want you to know that we're going to be making money for what we're doing. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
Now, when Mr. and Mrs. Bleeker come with the money woman, we have to act like nice little boys and girls.
We know. Mind our manners. Treat our elders with respect.
So they'll never know what we're really like.
Hey, here they come with the money lady. Grab your halos. We're on.
We've brought you a visitor, children. Miss Goldie Appleby.
Good afternoon, Miss Appleby.
Good afternoon.
Gee, Mr. and Mrs. Bleeker, we're awful sorry we didn't get to finish the kitchen.
It's all right, my dear.
It's because we have a big surprise for you.
Today's your birthday, Mr. Bleeker.
Oh, Mother, I forgot.
And for your kindness, we all chipped in to buy you a little present.
Oh, isn't that sweet?
Our spokesman, Grinelda Themer, will present the gift. Grinelda Themer.
A birthday cake.
Thank you. Miss Appleby, it's moments like these that make life worth living.
Yes. Boy, if she swallows this, she'll swallow anything.
Grinelda, that was so sweet of you.
We may be wanted, ragged and poor, but thanks to the Bleakers, we're happy. Gee, you're a pretty lady.
Thank you, Grinelda.
I told you over-rehearsed them.
I almost went nuts getting them this good.
Mr. Bleaker, they're such wonderful children.
Oh, yes, we picked the best.
We picked the children who needed us the most.
They're so well-behaved. Believe me, you've done a great job.
Thank you, Miss Appleby. It wasn't easy.
Mr. Bleaker, what can I do for them?
Well, look, Miss Appleby, we don't want to burden you with our problems. Oh, I admit these are humble beginnings, but somehow, somewhere, we'll raise the $20,000.
Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thank you. How much did you say?
$20,000, but it isn't your problem. May I give you a piece of my birthday cake?
Mr. Bleaker, I've never known people like you before to share your little humble cake with me. Please let me help. There must be something I can do.
But how could a pretty young girl like you possibly raise $20,000?
Well, it just so happens that I have a few connections. Believe me when I tell the Strickland Foundation the story I saw here, I'll raise that money just like that.
Miss Appleby, I just can't believe that we found someone who cares.
Thank you, Money Lady. Thank you, Money Lady.
You're welcome. You know something, kids? You and Mr. and Mrs. Bleaker have been through enough. From now on, your Aunt Goldie is taking over. Bye, Grinelda. Bye, kids. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Wow, what a sucker.
To think adults trust us.
No, Goldie, absolutely no.
Would you please turn the record over?
Look, Goldie, you know perfectly well the Foundation would never authorize a check for such a project. Unless, of course, they had time to investigate it.
Investigated? Oh, now there's a big deal. Maybe I should call Elsa Maxwell and have her check it out for you. Gee, Mr. Seaton, if you could have been there with me to see those kids, one little girl in rags, little tiny one, walked up to Mr. Bleaker and gave him a cupcake for his birthday. And then she gave me a great big kiss. If she could have kissed you, then maybe you'd know the emotions I'm feeling now.
Goldie, don't you think she's a bit young for me?
Oh, Mr. Seaton, will you please get off it? I'm serious. You gotta listen to me.
Well, it's up to you, Goldie. You sign the checks. But do you think it fair to gamble with money which belongs to the Strickland children?
No. No, I guess you're right. It's not right to do that. But you know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to raise that money on my own.
On your own? But how?
I will get it, Mr. Seaton, if I have to knock on every door in New York City. Don't you worry. You just stay here in your safe little cubicle. Sit on your money. Count it. Feel it. I'm going to get it.
How?
By walking. That's how.
You.
Why, what's up?
That phone has been ringing constantly for the past hour. Every dowager in Park Avenue has called and asked for you.
Roy, I'm in. Oh, boy, am I happy. I'll take the rest of the phone calls in my room. I'm pooped.
I should be so pooped.
I made it by walking. $20,000.
Oh, isn't this pretty? So green, so crunchy.
And so easy on the eyes. It's quite a haul. Do you mind if I count it?
Be my guest. Everybody chipped in.
Oh, I've never seen this much loot before.
Mr. Mrs. Bleeker, you must be very proud of this young woman.
Oh, we are.
We are.
You'll never know how much.
Oh, we couldn't have pulled this off without her. Without Miss Appleby, this could never have happened.
Sure it could.
No, we couldn't.
All I did was collect it.
You know something, Mr. Carter? It's a funny thing. If their car hadn't broken down right in front of my house, all of this never would have happened. It's like fate.
Yes, just like fate.
And it came off right on time.
Look at the happiness that money brings them. You see, they've given up their whole lives for those children, and now that money's going to make their dreams come true.
Hurry up. We've got to get out of here and get those brats back to their parents.
You people don't have to go to the trouble to take the money home. I'll open an account for you.
Oh, no, Mr. Carter, don't bother. But that's very nice of you, but we prefer to take the money with us.
We give stamps.
You see, Miss Appleby, being elderly people, we don't put much stock in banks.
Well,
I know how they feel. You know something? I'm the same way. To this day, I still keep my money in one of my old dancing belts.
Yeah. Isn't that interesting?
This is such a great occasion. Why don't you three people stand together and I'll take your picture for you?
No, thank you.
I've never been turned down before.
Everyone has a silly superstition, and that's ours. Not to have our picture taken.
You're going to be famous. You'll have your names in every paper in town.
That's what we're afraid of. Well, we have to be getting back to the children. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye.
Roy, I'm on cloud nine. I've been kissing bank tellers, cops on the beat, perfect strangers. I just turned over $20,000 to Bleakers.
Oh, no. No.
What do you mean, oh, no? What's the matter?
Can't do it. You sell her.
Everything, Goldie.
Mr. Seaton, what are you doing here? What's wrong?
Well, to put it bluntly, it seems your friends, the Bleakers, turn out to be a couple of old-time prestidigitators.
What Mr. Seaton is trying to tell you is they're a couple of con artists.
What do you mean, con artists?
They make money disappear. As they say in the vernacular, pigeon, you've been taken.
I don't believe it.
The Strickland Corporation has had private detectives following them for a week. That house they showed you through was just rented 2 weeks ago for a 1 month stay.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. And you're left holding the proverbial bag. Read her the files, Mr. Seaton.
Harry Bleeker, alias Horace Beamer, alias Harrison Boomer, born 1910, New York City. Slum area known as Hell's Kitchen. Never known to have held a job. Well-known bunco artist, 12 arrests, no convictions.
But I just can't believe it. That sweet old couple.
Sweet old couple of crooks.
But Roy, Mr. Seaton, those wonderful little orphans.
Slight correction, Goldie. The kids aren't orphans. They rented them.
I guess I know an orphan when I see one.
Don't you see, Goldie? They use the kids for the clincher.
How do you like that? The old pigeon game.
That's about it.
What's the matter, Goldie?
Don't anybody move. Look at me real good. You are now witnessing, before your very eyes, the greatest transformation of the ages. Goldie is now changing from the sensitive, naive, stupid person into a bitter, cynical, uncaring person. In other words, I'm gonna become a human being!
Well, Roy, are you ready?
I can't wait.
Come on.
Maybe this is the greatest racket I ever came up with.
You can say that again.
Oh, Larry. What a sucker. 20 G's, just like that.
You know, the kids for the clincher, they fall for them every time.
Hi. It's me.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi. I thought I'd drop off to tell you that everything is going just great.
Well, that's wonderful.
I thought you'd like to hear that. You see, everyone I've talked to, well, they think that you and Mrs. Bleeker are so wonderful. I mean, giving up your whole lives for children.
We just do what we can.
Well, the reason we love children is because, we never had any of our own.
Oh, what a shame. You would have been such wonderful parents.
Yeah. Well, that's why we founded the Bleeker foster home. It has been a tough fight, but thanks to the money you raised, we're really going places.
Yes, you can go quite a few places on $20,000. Oh, but that's nothing, Mr. Bleeker. Believe me, with the money I got coming in now, this joint will be jumping. I mean with kids.
That makes us very happy.
You know something, Mr. Bleeker? You two, you sort of get me right here.
Let's not talk about us.
Oh, but when I think of those poor, ragged, tattered... No. You stay right here. I'll see who it is.
Oh, please. I saw your sign. Please, can I come in? Please.
Don't overdo it. Oh, you poor child. Mr. Bleeker, look. I'm sure he hasn't eaten in a week.
Not even a candy bar.
Oh, Emma, don't just stand there. Get this poor boy some food.
Where were you born, son?
I was born in the slums, ma'am. Way down in Hell's Kitchen. If you'll pardon the expression.
You were. That's where I was born.
Oh, you poor little ragamuffin.
I may be poor, but now that I'm here, I'm happy.
Was your father good to you?
Oh, terrible. Beat me all the time. Everybody beat me. I'm just the littlest.
I know how you feel, son. Everybody beat me, too. I was the littlest.
Father beat me. My mother beat me. The butlers beat me.
The butler? Oh, you mean the butlers that lived in your neighborhood, maybe?
Yeah, the Hollister butlers. They lived upstairs from us.
Well, son, you won't have to worry anymore. You saw that sign outside. If nobody wants you, they do. Right, Mr. and Mrs. Bleeker? You now have found a home. Bye.
Have another cookie, son.
Hi, Goldie.
Hi, Lurie.
I just snuck out of the house.
Why did I have a hard time? They like me.
I'm telling you, that method works. I've been scratching so much, I think I've got the same bite as Dad's.
Hear me good. We are ready to put my get back at them like they got at me plan into action.
Well, you just made it because they're getting ready to leave right now. What's the plan?
It's a zagoomer. Follow me. Come on, kids. Hurry up. Out you go. Out you go. Now, remember, play the same scene for them like you played for me. Like identical. And Grinelda, don't Don't forget that kissing bit. That really got me.
It does everybody.
Goldie, what's this all about? Who are they?
They are the same so-called orphans that those phony bleakers rented to get me to put the money up.
You mean they're gonna go in there and reenact the scene?
Go, go.
You know, a buck here, a buck there. It all adds up.
Hey, what's that for?
Well, don't you see, Roy? She may be poor and ragged, but that's part of the act.
Oh, no, money lady. You're wrong. I meant it. Zowie, like you're the most.
Boy, I can't wait to see the bleakers' faces when I hit them with the same jazz they hit me with. Come on, ragamuffin.
You got everything packed, Harry?
Yeah, including the money. Hey, where's that new kid, the real orphan?
Well, he's probably outside playing rich. You know, I guess you're going to think this is kind of stupid, but I'm beginning to fall for that kid. He reminds me so much of you.
I know, Emma. I feel the same way. Ah, we can't afford to have emotions. After all, we're crooks. Crooks ain't supposed to have emotions. Ah, he's better off without us.
I guess you're right. We don't deserve them.
Hi, Mr. Bleaker. It's me again.
Oh, no.
I brought some of your rented friends with me.
Oh, Mr. Bleaker!
Please, I love you, Mr. Bleaker. Please let me stay here with you.
Mr. Bleaker, we're so poor now, they're tearing down our house and putting up slums.
It's moments like these that make life worthwhile. Right, Mr. Bleaker?
Grinnell, will you please stop kissing me?
How are you doing?
You kids did a wonderful job. Now, go outside and I have cars waiting for you. Bye.
Okay, it's your deal, Miss Appleby. You found us out.
What are you going to do with us?
I'm going to give you a choice.
You're going to give us a choice?
Either you spend the next few years of your life with a lovely view of the cell across the hall, or you keep the money.
Keep the money?
That's right. And have a real orphanage. There's lots of kids who really need a home and wonderful surroundings. And they'd never have a chance except for people like you. Well, do you care?
Harry, she's given us another chance. We're not getting any younger, and they could be like our own kids, and we could raise them and love them and be like real parents. We'll go straight, Harry. She's given us a chance to go straight.
Miss Appleby, deep down, I think it's what we've always wanted.
Mr. Bleaker, I believe you. I always have. That's why I've gone so far. Oh, Roy.
Roy?
Oh, sure. You see, he belongs to me. You were right, Mrs. Bleaker. Kids are the clincher every time. They get you right here.
And to think adults trust us.